Next type of questions. Write in the simplest form. Tan inverse root of 1 plus x square minus 1 by x, where x not equal to 0. If x is equal to 0, denominator 0 means it is not defined. That's why it's given x not equal to 0. Write in the simplest form. Again, the outside is tan inverse. So, what we do is convert this bracket in terms of tan. So, we get a simplified answer. So, we can convert this bracket in terms of tan by using suitable substitution for this x. So, what is the substitution? Substitution usually we give trigonometric functions. So, which function we can give? Sine, cos, tan, which one we can give? So, you have to, there is an easy method, that is, if it is 1 minus x square form. 1 minus x square, we use this identity, sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. So, 1 minus, if x is sin theta or cos theta, if x is sin theta, what is 1 minus sin square theta, that is cos square theta. If x is cos theta, 1 minus cos square theta is sin square theta, that is we get an answer. So, if the format 1 minus x square, you can give x as sin theta or cos theta. Then we have another identity. Here we have it is 1 plus x square. So, we use this identity 6 square theta minus tan square theta is equal to 1. Or we have one more identity. What is that identity? Cosec square theta minus cot square theta is equal to 1. So, 1 plus tan square theta gives 6 square theta, or 1 plus cot square theta gives cosec square theta. So, if it is 1 plus x square form, we can give x as tan theta or cot theta. Then, one more format, that is x square minus 1. If x square minus 1, if x is sec theta, what is 6 square theta minus 1? We get tan square theta. Or cosec square theta minus 1 is cot square theta. So, for this type of x square minus 1, if that is in the bracket, we can put x as sec theta or cosec theta. So, that you have to remember. Then using that, what is the substitution for this x? If it is 1 plus x square form, you can give x as tan theta or cot theta. So, here I put x as, let x is equal to tan theta, let x is equal to tan theta. Then, this question becomes, tan inverse root of 1 plus x square minus 1 by x, that's equal to tan inverse, what is 1 plus tan square theta, minus 1 by denominator also tan theta, 1 plus tan square theta is equal to 6 square theta, 6 square theta root is sec theta. So, sec theta minus 1 by tan theta. Again, we can simplify this. So, tan inverse. Sec theta means it is 1 by cos theta. 1 by cos theta minus 1 by tan is sin by cos. Then, next step, tan inverse. 1 minus cos theta by cos theta, taking the reciprocal, cos theta by sin theta. So, cos theta cancel. So, tan inverse of 1 minus cos theta by sin theta. Then, outside is tan inverse. So, here again we have to do simplification, then only we can convert this into tan. So, 1 minus cos theta. How we write 1 minus cos theta? 1 minus cos theta, we have this result, 1 minus cos theta is equal to 2 sine square theta by 2. So, the numerator is tan inverse 2 sine square theta by 2. So, the angle is theta by 2. And the denominator is sine theta, that is it's not in terms of half angle. So, we have to convert, then only cancellation is possible. So, sine theta we can write as sine theta is equal to 2 sine theta by 2 cos theta by 2. 2 sine theta by 2 cos theta by 2. Now, we can cancel. 2 cancel. 1 sine theta by 2 cancel. So, what is left? Tan inverse of sin theta by 2 by cos theta by 2. That is same as tan theta by 2. Tan inverse tan theta by 2. So, what we get? Theta by 2. Then we have to replace. Since we put substitution, the question is in terms of x. So, we have to replace theta. What is theta? X is equal to tan theta implies theta is equal to tan inverse of x. So, the answer is half of. This is half of theta, that is the meaning. So, half of tan inverse x. Okay. Once again, children, this type questions are important. Tan inverse root of 1 plus x square minus 1 by x. So, outside check always the outside function. It is tan inverse, convert bracket in terms of tan. So, you have to do appropriate substitution. For that substitution, this you have to keep in your mind. Okay. So, if it is 1 plus x square, you can give tan theta or cot theta. We can do cot theta also. So, look here. Here I put x as tan theta. Then, when we give x as tan theta, numerator becomes sec theta minus 1, denominator is tan theta. Then we write in terms of cos and sine. So, we get what we get 1 minus cos theta by sin theta. Again, we give 1 minus cos theta as 2 sin square theta by 2 and sin theta as 2 sin theta by 2 cos theta by 2. So, last we get tan theta by 2 or theta by 2. So, half of theta, that is half of tan inverse x. So, here I did x as substitution as tan theta. Then what about cot theta? That also we can try. So, let or let x is equal to cot theta. So, tan inverse of the question is root of 1 plus x square minus 1. Correct, root of 1 plus x square minus 1 by x. So, this becomes tan inverse of 1 plus cot square theta, that is cosec square theta. So, root is cosec theta. Cosec theta minus 1 by cot theta. Then tan inverse, cosec means 1 by sine. Minus 1 by cos theta by sin theta. So, sin theta we can cancel. So, that becomes tan inverse of 1 minus sin theta by cos theta. Again, cos theta. Cos theta, we have to convert this into a single function. Then only we get the answer. So, cos theta we can write as cos square theta by 2 minus sin square theta by 2. Isn't it? This is from the equation cos 2 theta. Cos 2 theta is equal to cos square theta minus sin square theta. So, cos theta we can write as cos square theta by 2 minus sin square theta by 2. So, that is tan inverse of denominator part is cos square theta by 2 minus sin square theta by 2. So what about the numerator? That also we have to express in terms of half angle. So 1 minus sin theta. Children, in the last class I have given that 1 minus sin theta as a perfect square. You remember that 1 minus sin theta as cos theta by 2 minus sin theta by 2 whole square. Or it is sin theta by 2 minus cos theta by 2 whole square. Okay. So here which we write, denominator is cos square minus sin square. So better you can take cos theta by 2 minus sin theta by 2 whole square. Then only cancellation possible. So numerator is cos theta by 2 minus sin theta by 2 whole square. Then, so that's equal to tan inverse cos theta by 2 minus sin theta by 2 whole square by denominator is a square minus b square 4, a plus b into a minus b. So cos theta by 2 minus sin theta by 2 is one factor. Next one is cos theta by 2 plus sin theta by 2. So we can cancel this. Then again, this lengthy one. So tan inverse of cos theta by 2 minus sin theta by 2 by cos theta by 2 plus sin theta by 2. Then again simplification, we have to convert to tan. So we divide throughout by cos theta by 2. Numerator and denominator we can divide. So no need of multiplication, just divide the numerator and denominator by cos theta by 2. So cos theta by 2 minus sin theta by 2 by cos theta by 2 divided by cos theta by 2 plus sin theta by 2 by cos theta. So that is tan inverse of divide, split it and divide. Cos theta by 2 by cos theta by 2 is 1. Then 1 minus sin theta by 2 by cos theta by 2 is tan theta by 2. Denominator cos theta by 2 by cos theta by 2 is plus 1. Then plus sin theta by 2 by cos theta by 2 is tan theta. Then the next step is 1 we can write as tan inverse. 1 is same as tan pi by 4. So tan pi by 4 minus tan theta by 2 by this one write as 1 itself. And here we have tan theta by 2. And here I just write tan pi by 4. Tan pi by 4 is 1. So 1 into tan theta by 2 is tan theta by 2. Why did I write like this? This is a result. What is the result? Tan a plus b or tan x plus y. Tan a plus b. Here it is minus. Sorry. So what is tan a minus b? Tan a minus b is tan A minus tan B divided by 1 plus tan A tan B. Now you compare this with this. Is this bracket in this form? Okay. So that answer is tan A minus B. So we can write that's equal to tan inverse of tan A minus B. What is in the place of A? A is pi by 4. And b is theta by 2. Okay. So tan inverse tan pi by 4 minus theta by 2. We can just write pi by 4 minus theta by 2. Now we can replace theta. What was the substitution? X is equal to cot theta. So theta is cot inverse x. So minus 1 by 2 cot inverse x. Okay, we can convert this in terms of tan. pi by 4 minus half into cot inverse x is tan inverse x plus cot inverse x is equal to pi by 2. Another property. So cot inverse x means pi by 2 minus tan inverse x. So pi by 4 minus pi by 4 plus half tan inverse x. These two cancel, half tan inverse x. Is it same as the first one? The first answer we got as half tan inverse x, isn't it? Look, half tan inverse x. So when we put x as cot theta, we get the answer, but it is lengthy one. So here, better you give x as tan theta. Okay. So go through it. Tan inverse root of 1 plus x square minus 1 by x. We put x as tan theta. Then we get half tan inverse x. You can do with cot theta also, but it is lengthy one. So you write both in the notebook. Okay. Both the method. So lengthy one. It's half tan inverse. Next question, write in the simplest form, that's the question, write in the simplest form, tan inverse 1 by root of x square minus 1, we have to write in simplest form. So just like x by 2, theta by 2, in that way we have to write the answer. So here, this part in the denominator, tan inverse of, so the technique is we have to convert this bracket in terms of tan. So the numerator is 1. So 1 by what is tan? 1 by cot. So here you have to get cot. Then only that becomes tan. So what is the substitution for x? We have to get cot theta. So cot tan which are related, that identity which are related, or if x square minus 1. What is the, if x square minus 1 is the format, you can give x as, what is the substitution, either sec theta or cosec theta. So here we need cot theta, that's why I put x as cosec theta. Okay. So let x is equal to cosec theta. So tan inverse of 1 by root of x square minus 1, that's equal to tan inverse of 1 by root of cosec square theta minus 1. That's equal to tan inverse of 1 by cot theta. Cosec square theta minus 1 is cot square theta. Its root is cot theta. So this becomes tan inverse of tan theta. And that's equal to theta. Theta means what is theta? Theta is equal to cosec inverse x. And here look children, modulus x greater than 1. Modulus x greater than 1 means when we square it, x square is greater than 1. If x square is greater than 1, then only this root is defined. We know that root should be greater than or equal to 0. But equal to 0 is not possible since it is in the denominator. So it should be greater than 0. That's why the condition is given. Otherwise, the function is not defined. So here the answer is cosec inverse x. And next one. Tan inverse root of 1 minus cos x by 1 plus cos x. For 1 minus cos x and 1 plus cos x, we have the results. Do you study all these results? 1 minus cos x is 2 sin square x by 2. And 1 plus cos x is 2 cos square x by 2. So we can write tan inverse root of 2 sin square x by 2 by 2 cos square x by 2. 2 cancel. Sin square by cos square is tan square. So that is tan x by 2. So that's equal to x by 2. The answer is in terms of x. Here we didn't put any substitution, so answer x by 2. Now the fourth one, tan inverse cos x minus sin x by cos x plus sin x. And this part is in the first question, that is OR type, the second method, when I put x as cot theta, that substitution, then we got like this after some steps. So there we divide. If tan is outside, tan inverse is outside, we have to convert this in terms of tan. Tan means sine by cos. So here we need by cos. So you have to divide by cos. So whenever you get a term like this, you have to divide throughout by cos, or divide the numerator and denominator by cos. So divide numerator and denominator by cos x. So tan inverse cos x minus sin x by cos x plus sin x. So that's equal to tan inverse dividing. So cos x minus sin x by cos x. Then denominator is cos x plus sin x. Then by cos x. Okay. So that's equal to cos x by cos x. That is 1. You can't simply cancel this cos x. That is wrong. You have to divide each term by cos x. So 1 minus tan x by 1 plus tan x. Now we have to convert 1 in terms of tan. So that's equal to tan inverse. 1 is same as tan pi by 4 minus tan x by 1 plus. That one is 1 itself. So tan A minus tan B by 1 plus tan A into tan B, that form. So just multiply by tan pi by 4 into tan S. So that is tan inverse of tan A minus B. Is this step clear? Instead of 1, we can write tan pi by 4. So tan pi by 4 minus tan x, and for this denominator 1 we can't give tan pi by 4. Why? This 1, you have to compare that with the result tan A minus B. Tan A minus B is tan A minus tan B, and 1 plus this 1 is in the result. So this 1 you can't change, that 1 keep as itself. And the second term you have to just multiply by tan pi by 4. Tan pi by 4 is 1. So its value not change. So we write this in this form. Then only we can write that as tan of pi by 4 minus x. Tan of A minus B. So the answer is pi by 4 minus x. One more question. Tan inverse 3a square x minus x cube by a cube minus 3ax square. Here range of x is given. So is there any result similar to tan function? Tan 2 theta. So just you go through tan 2 theta, tan 3 theta, like that. 3, starting with 3 we have this result tan 3 theta. What is tan 3 theta? Tan 3 theta is 3 tan theta minus tan cube theta by 1 minus 3 tan square theta. So here we have to arrange in that way. But here we have this a square a cube and all. So a we have to take outside. How can we take outside? So put substitution as, here when we take x as, the result is like this, 3 tan theta. So for this x we need tan theta, here tan cube theta. So 1 a square is here. So we have to take outside, means put x as a tan theta. So if x is a tan theta, here we get a cube. Here also we get a cube. So a cube we can take out. Here already a cube is there. Here a square means a into a square becomes a cube. So that a cube we can cancel. So put the substitution as x is equal to a tan theta. Now take the question. 3a square x minus x cube by a cube minus 3a x square, that's equal to tan inverse of 3a cube tan theta minus a cube tan cube theta by a cube minus 3a into a square tan square theta, that is a cube tan square theta. Take a cube outside, cancel. 3 tan theta minus tan cube theta by 1 minus 3 tan square theta. A cube cancel. So tan inverse of tan 3 theta, that's equal to 3 theta. When we can write tan inverse tan 3 theta as 3 theta, if 3 theta belongs to the range, what is the range of this function? Open interval minus pi by 2, pi by 2. So 3 theta, then we can replace theta. We can check that interval is given. X is equal to a tan theta implies tan theta is equal to, what is tan theta? X by a. Tan theta is equal to x by a. Then what is theta? Theta is equal to tan inverse x by a. Okay. Once again, if x is equal to a tan theta is equal to x by a. Then theta is equal to tan inverse x by a. So here we have 3 tan inverse x by a. Now we can verify the range is given minus a by root 3. Minus a by root 3 less than or equal to x. X means we put a tan theta. It's a substitution for x. Then a by root 3. A cancel. So, minus 1 by root 3 less than or equal to tan theta less than or equal to 1 by root 3. Then we apply tan inverse. So, tan inverse of minus 1 by root 3 less than or equal to, this becomes theta less than or equal to tan inverse 1 by root 3. 1 by root 3 means pi by 6. And minus 1 by root 3 means minus of that acute angle less than or equal to pi by 6. But we have 3 theta. So multiply throughout by 3 theta. So minus pi by 2 less than or equal to, less than or equal is not there. Let me check. Yes. It's theta, 3 theta less than or equal to pi by 2. So 3 theta is in that range. Okay. So once again go through this. We have to put the appropriate substitution x as a tan theta. When x is a tan theta, we can reduce, we can convert this bracket in terms of tan 3 theta. So the answer is 3 theta, or that's equal to 3 tan inverse x by a. So I hope all of you understood this. Thank you.